season that has turned pretty much all of its characters into stupid dum-dums who can't read a situation for shit because the plot needs them to be stupid.
And things have become kind of traditional format for people doing commentaries on Buffy, Angel, or Firefly. I want to do some more focused thematic essays, and this one will treat a very difficult topic, and not the only one of this nature. But here we're going to look at Seeing Red, specifically the abuse theme, and the way I'm going to argue it doesn't make any sense to use Spike and or Buffy within this particular scene. Again, I have no issue with the idea itself if they want to use this quote-unquote format. For an educational purpose, I myself think probably they shouldn't. I think using fiction to teach ethics and or education in a direct way is always very, very problematic. But Buffy, as the Buffyverse goes, has done this quite a few times. So there's nothing extraordinary with what they did with season 6. I think it's the way they did it and with which characters. And that really, really bothers me. This isn't the only time, of course. There are comparable examples elsewhere, especially in the Angelverse. And we'll get to that as we proceed with our discussion. The problem here is, of course, what is canonical? And how does the canon work with Buffy and Angel or the Whedonverse? I'd have to try to demonstrate that canon is important, or even that canon exists, or that we can even make sense of what a canon is, and then we can proceed that, well, this isn't legitimate, this is not a legitimate use of the characters, therefore I don't regard it as canon, therefore I don't think the writers did enough to establish this is a realistic or even plausible scenario. But I have to show this, and I'm going to do a separate essay on that, and I'll include a big portion of Buffy and Angel to prove my case. But that's a separate discussion, because what is canon is very difficult. I'll just take for granted that what occurred roughly seasons 1 to 5 is canon. And using that as the baseline, this does not appear to be Spike, and this does not appear to be Buffy. At the most simple level, everyone knows the basic problem with Seeing Red, which is, of course, Buffy has super strength. She has the power to sort of throw somebody off if somebody attacks her, period. It doesn't have to be a sexual assault. It could be any kind of assault. Buffy is now well-trained enough and has enough power, it's not going to happen. If anybody does try to do this thing, they'd have to be an extraordinary circumstance for it to even be plausible as even a form of action, because she can defend herself. So why is this happening? Now, it could happen, right, because we see in an earlier episode that Giles takes away her powers. But again, that's what's established, is that she's panicking that she doesn't have super strength. But nowhere in the episode is it ever implied she has a lack of super strength. She has her super strength. In fact, she even comments on this, saying she was able to stop Spike. It's unclear how this episode or this scene is supposed to work. Insofar as we know Buffy as a canonical character, she has a certain amount of power. She can stop what's happening. How is this happening and why is it happening? Now again, this isn't the only time, right? If we look at something like season 4 of Angel, we have a comparable example where Cordelia, for much of the season, doesn't really make a lot of sense. The way she's acting, the way she's talking, doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. Angel makes sense, and even Connor makes sense, given their motivations. But Cordelia feels really, really strange. And of course, we don't know why within the universe. Now we kind of do know why, right? Because there was a disagreement between Joss Whedon and Charisma Carpenter. So now we know the real world reason, but we don't know in terms of the fiction why this happened. We just know the character is not really acting the way the character should be acting. They're just acting very strangely. There's also additional problems if we take the canon seriously, because in Angel Season 1, it's established clearly that Buffy has more strength than Angel, which is pretty astonishing. So then when we look at the Angel-Spike scenes, comparatively, they struggle with one another because they have sort of co-equal strength. So if we can take for granted that Buffy is stronger than Angel, then by definition, she's stronger than Spike. So if this situation really played out, she should be able to just grab him and throw him against the wall, or throw him away by quite a long distance. So how or why is this scene happening? Well, it's clear they wanted something like this to happen. They were willing to allow Spike and Buffy as a couple, but they wanted the relationship to end. And they also wanted to teach something. Okay, that's fine if they legitimately want the couple as such to end. I'm not going to get into the whole Spuffy discussion because that would be too much of a tangent, but I don't have any issue with the couple itself. But okay, they want to dissolve it. All right, that's fine. That's totally legitimate if they want to end it for various reasons. But they want to couple it with another ethical lesson. And here, I think, is where things get very, very problematic. Because we have seen them in love before. In a season 4 episode in Buffy, we see them, yes, it's under magic, but they're totally in love with one another. Now, within that episode, we never see Spike being abusive at all. In fact, he's actually very helpful and he's very cooperative. He even tries to help Giles, who's suffering from blindness. We've seen the couple actually in love, and it's been these two identical characters. And in that situation, they were not abusive to one another. So if there are, quote, hints of abuse in Spike, they were not shown with Buffy. Now, one could argue that Spike himself has a history of abuse. There is some legitimacy in bringing that up. Well, no, there isn't, because when it is brought up, it's often brought up for laughs. So in season 4, there is a scene which is really bizarre between him and Willow, where he attempts to attack her, right? But he has the chip, so he can't. But that's played for laughs. There's a kind of inconsistency within the writing itself of treating the topic seriously, but insofar as they treated the topic, they kind of treated it sort of as a laughable issue, not as a serious one. So there's that problem. But even putting that aside, when we look at the actual history of, quote, abuse by Spike, it's a little bit more complicated because, yes, you can say at certain times he was abusive towards Drusilla, but it's also the case that Drusilla was abusive towards him. So there are clearly certain moments where Spike feels abused and feels manipulated, and he says so. And we see enough scenes where that seems like a plausible interpretation. But of course, we do see moments where Spike chains up Drusilla clearly against her will. So he is willing to be, quote, abusive in a generic sense. But is he willing to be abusive in this specific sense? I don't think we'll give any hints of that at all. In fact, given all we know about the character and how passionate he is, he's willing to be emotionally abusive, like he was with Harmony. He even tries to kill her at a point. But why would he want to sexually assault, quote, ex-woman he's in love with or passionate about? We never ever see anything like that, or why the motivation would even be there is not really explained. They just want that to be there to try to have this kind of ethical lesson about abuse. And abuse is a major theme within the Buffyverse. That's fine, but it seems a solution could have been easily made. And given Dawn, we even have precedent. Why don't they just create a distant relative of Willow and or Xander, namely a half-brother or a distant cousin, give that person a certain amount of super strength, and there you go. We can at least believe that might happen, and Buffy might hesitate because they don't want to hurt the person. But she knows Spike. She knows how much punishment he can take. He's going to recover eventually. Again, there's just a lot within the whole scene that does not make sense. In fact, the scene itself is a contradiction to itself, because if you notice closely with the clothing, Sarah Michelle Gellar is not naked. So how is Spike going to do what he's going to do? He'd have to, again, just looking at the scene, tear her clothes off. That's going to take time. Within that time period, clearly Buffy can grab him and stop him. Even within the scene itself, it really, really doesn't make sense in terms of the way they choreographed the act. It just seems they just wanted something to happen, an incident that would dissolve the relationship, and they simultaneously want to teach a lesson. Again, if they want to teach a lesson, that's fine, but we have to take seriously the writing for us to take the lesson seriously. If they're just going to play with the theme, but not really think it through, then I'm not obligated to take this writing seriously at all. So if the question is this a canonical scene? The answer that I would think is no, because it just doesn't make sense with the character. At least not what was established earlier, very carefully through other scenes. So we have a kind of problem here. Either we think the theme is strong enough that, okay, it doesn't make sense in terms of canon, but it's worth talking about. But then we don't need the characters to talk about it. We can just talk about the subject with or without the character. I mean, for instance, when Dawn is in danger in season 5, we're literally having the prospect of putting one life against trillions of lives. That's an insane amount of lives that you're possibly putting in danger for one life. So you're clearly not treating the subject seriously to say, well, we're not even going to talk about sacrificing Dawn. Well, when trillions of lives are at stake, clearly people would rationally discuss whether one person's life is worth the value of trillions of other lives. That just doesn't make any sense to say, we're not even going to have a discussion about it, as Buffy says. That's ridiculous. No logical person would agree with that. So again, it's fine if you're going to teach a lesson, but you have to do at least a good enough job in constructing the scene or constructing the episode or constructing the writing that it makes sense to talk about the theme. If it's going to just be braised in an abstract kind of manipulative sense, like they did with Dawn, well, I can say many things about season 5, which I think is one of the best Buffy seasons, but in terms of Dawn and her value as a character, it doesn't make any sense at all. At all, period. It just would not make sense to weigh one life against trillions of others and say, we're not even going to have a utilitarian discussion. Clearly, many people would, and many people will, and they're not trying to be vicious towards Dawn. Again, just a lot of problems with seeing Red, and it's not the only time, right? They've kind of violated the canon or just manipulated the characters to an insane degree. But of all the cases, this is probably one of the most notorious cases because, again, they could have found an alternative, but they just got lazy. They just wanted the most popular character in the Buffyverse at that time, and it was clearly Spike. Let's just use him because he's widely well-known. He's widely beloved, and we're going to have a polarizing episode. Well, I don't care if it's polarizing or not. It has to at least be plausible. And for me, seeing Red is just not getting up there in terms of plausibility. So I just have to regard it as not canonical. So to even get started in a conversation, I'd have to say, yeah, I don't really take that thing too seriously. If you want to talk about the issue itself, that's fine. But don't bring up that episode or that scene. It just doesn't make sense to do so. It just, to me, is way too ridiculous to even try to take seriously. This has been a video essay on the issues of interpreting Seeing Red within the Buffyverse. Thanks for listening.